The calculate function is one of the most powerful functions in DAX. It's also a very special function because it's different. Usually functions calculate from left to right, but the calculate function doesn't work like that. The definition of the function itself can also be quite confusing to understand. So my attempt is to summarize this definition to a single word, which I'm pretty sure you'll understand. Okay, so that single word is pivot table. At least in Excel, it's considered one word. If you're like, what?
Say what?
Let me explain. First of all, in case you're not familiar with the calculate function, let me quickly explain what it does. So here I have total sales per month in 2021. With the calculate function, I could do something like this. I could get the sales of innovative products. Now, whether a product is innovative or not is not part of my initial filter context. I can't see that in the pivot table. That filter is added directly to the measure. I could go beyond this and get the sales of innovative products that were bought in bulk. So whether the product was bought in bulk or not is also a filter that was added to the measure. These filters are added to the filter context that we see in our visual. So here I'm in Excel, I'm using a pivot table, but the same concept applies if you're using any type of visual in Power BI. The calculate function has the ability to completely change the filter context that's coming in from your visual. The way these filters are applied is the same way a pivot table applies filters. And this concept makes it so much easier to understand how the calculate function actually works and why it does what it does. So let's rewind and let's visualize what's happening in the background when we do these types of calculations. Okay, so here I have total sales per month. First of all, let me show you quickly the data model to see how our data is organized. So over here in the sales table, I have a separate column for quantity and sales price. To get total sales, I've used the SUMX function and multiplied the quantity column with the sales price. So this is an iterator function. We are going row by row, multiplying quantity with sales price and adding up the results. In the products table here, I have my product master data, and one of these columns is the type of product, and that is whether the product is a standard product or if it's an innovative product. There is a relationship between the products table and the sales table. That relationship is defined by the product code. Now, I want to create a measure that gets us the total sales of innovative products. Let's go to Measures, New Measure, call this Sales Innovative Products, and start with the calculate function. So first thing we need is the expression. This is the expression that we want to change based on the additional filters that we're going to be adding on top of the initial filters that are coming from the pivot table. The expression that we want to change is total sales. The filters that I want to add in this case is just one filter, and that's if product type. So I'm just going to type in type, and I can see the product table here. I'm going to check whether this equals innovative. Now, this is not case sensitive, so it doesn't matter if I put a capital I or a small I. It's going to work either way. Let's close the bracket and adjust the number formatting to a currency. Now, click on OK, and I get the total sales of innovative products. Now, it's difficult to see what's really happening in the background and how that additional filter is being added by Calculate. So let's do an exercise and visualize what's happening in a separate pivot table. I'm just going to copy this initial pivot table, paste it here, and now remove the measures that we have. You see, the way the calculate function works is that it applies the initial filters that we have in the pivot table, just like any other measure, but then it adds the filters that are inside the calculate function, and last, it calculates the expression. Sounds a bit confusing, but it's much easier to remember if we can visualize it. Okay, so first we start off with this filter. This is the filter that's coming in from the pivot table. Next, we have a filter in the calculate function. That filter is whether a product is innovative or not. So let's add that to our second pivot table. That was type in the product table, and we're going to filter this for innovative products. Now the expression gets calculated. That expression is total sales. Take a look at what we have here. 10,972, it's what we see here. Then it's 24,042, what we see here. These are identical, and this is identical. So this is basically what the calculate function does. It adds an invisible pivot table with its own filters to the initial pivot table or visual that you see. And then it makes the calculation. And then it puts that value inside the measure that you've defined here. Now let's add the second measure, sales of innovative products that were bought in bulk. I'll call it sales innovative bulk purchase. So let's assume that we define bulk purchase for any transaction where the quantity was greater than 10. Now, let's use the calculate function to get that. The expression is total sales, so that's the measure that we want to change based on these additional filters that we're going to add. One filter was that type from the products table equals innovative. The other filter, so I'm going to add the next argument, is that quantity was greater than 10. So that's quantity from the sales table greater than 10. Close bracket. Let's adjust the number formatting and add this to our pivot table. So here we have much smaller numbers. Can we visualize that as well? Sure we can. We have an additional filter that we've added directly to our measure. Let's bring it out so we can see it here. That filter is for quantity. I'm not going to add quantity to the values here, but quantity to the rows, because quantity here is acting as a filter. Let's filter that by going to label filters, right? Not value filters. These are values that you have inside your pivot table. Quantity is a label in this case. We want to check whether this is greater than 10. Click on OK. And now check what we get. For January, it's the sum of these two. That gives us 1,637. That's what we see here. February, 7,033. April, it's the sum of these two values, 2,523. That's basically what the calculate function does. Any filters you define are added to this invisible pivot table that's then added on top of the visible pivot table. The expression is then calculated. The final value is put inside the measure that you define. Okay, so that's my explanation of the calculate function. Let me know in the comments what you think. Now, there is a lot more that calculate can do. You can use it together with the filter function or other table functions to do more complex calculations, which you can't do with the standard filter of calculate. Or you can use it to also write your own time intelligence functions. In case you'd like to master Power Pivot DAX and data modeling, check out my complete course on excelplus.com. In fact, it's three courses in one because we create impressive dashboards in the course as well. Many thanks for watching, and I'm going to see you in the next video.